गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डील विद पार्ट थ्री ऑफ चैप्टर लाइट फिजिक्स एंड टुडे वी विल डील विद द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू स्फेरिकल मिरर. अर्लियर आई हैव गिवन यू इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ प्लेन एंड स्फेरिकल मिरर एंड अलॉन्ग विद दैट रे डायग्राम फॉर्मेशन इन स्फेरिकल मिरर. बिफोर गोइंग फर्दर आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट शेयर सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड गिव दिस नॉलेज टू अदर्स ऑल्सो बाई शेयरिंग इट. Okay, and let us start with it. Now, first one is that for numerical related problems, we have to first seek sign convention for spherical mirrors, without which these numericals may be wrong. In case of spherical mirror, all signs are taken from the pole of the spherical mirror, which is often called as origin or original point. So this sign convention is known as New Cartesian sign convention. I mean to say, ये स्फेरिकल मिरर है तो इसके सेंटर में जो पोल का ये पॉइंट है इसे ओरिजिन पॉइंट बोलते हैं और ओरिजिन बोलते हैं. फ्रॉम इस पॉइंट से सारे डिस्टेंसेस मेजर किए जाएंगे. ये कहा था न्यू कार्टेशियन साइन कन्वेंशन ने. नाउ फर्स्ट वन इज दैट साइन इज टेकन एज नेगेटिव फ्रॉम द पोल ऑफ अ स्फेरिकल मिरर टुवर्ड अलोंग द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. ये साइन कार्टेशियन रूल ये कहता है कि डायरेक्शन ऑफ लाइट में जितने भी डिस्टेंसेज आएंगे वो सब पॉजिटिव होंगे. हम जनरली वी कीप दिस ऑब्जेक्ट और ल्यूमिनस ऑब्जेक्ट विच पुट लाइट ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट एट द बैक ऑफ इट दैट इज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड एंड लाइट गोज फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट साइड टुवर्ड द राइट साइड. सो ऑल द डिस्टेंसेज विच आर टुवर्ड द राइट साइड दे विल बी मेजर्ड एज पॉजिटिव, वेयर एज द डिस्टेंसेज विच आर ऑपोजिट टू दिस पॉइंट दैट इज टुवर्ड द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड दे विल बी इन द नेगेटिव manner. Okay, another thing is that all the things which are upright they will have positive sign and all the things which are in downward direction they will have negative sign. Generally upright position is of the object and downward position is of the image for the real and inverted image. Okay, so this is about it. Let us see what is written here. Sign is taken as negative from pole of a spherical mirror toward object along the principal axis. This means sign is given taken as negative in front of a spherical mirror. For example, the distance of object is always taken as negative in both the cases of concave and convex mirror. So yahan se jitne bhi objects rakhe jate hain wo left side pe hi hote hain. You know that whether that's for concave mirror or convex mirror. Okay, so the distance from pole to the object is called as object distance, that is always negative whether that's a concave mirror or convex mirror. Second is sign is taken as positive behind the spherical mirror. For example, if the image is formed behind the mirror, the distance of image is taken as positive from the pole along the principal axis. So all the distances which are behind the mirror, they are positive, and generally that is the virtual and erect image in case of concave mirror. So we take that distance from the pole to the image as positive because that is on the right hand side. Next is the height of any object is taken as positive above the principal axis and taken as negative below the principal axis. So generally for object height sign is positive, for image height it is generally negative, but may be positive also for the virtual and erect image. So this is the sign convention in case of concave mirror. In general it was there, but let us see what is the sign convention for the concave mirror. Now for the concave mirror, object distance is always taken as negative, that is distance from the pole to the object is negative since it's on the left hand side. Since the center of curvature and focus is in front of the concave mirror, you know that it is in front, that is on the left hand side, so focal length is always taken as negative. Focal length is distance from the pole to the focus, that is small f, that is negative in this case. Next is when image is formed in front of the mirror, the distance of the image is taken as negative. Now this is the image, distance from the pole to the image is also negative when it is real and inverted, but it is positive when it is virtual and erect and behind the mirror. Next, height of the image is taken as positive in case of the erect image and taken as negative in case of the inverted image. For this, this height of the object is positive for the erect image, but this height of the image is taken as negative for the real and inverted image. Next one is sine in the case of convex mirror. For the convex mirror, object is always placed in front of the mirror, so object distance is negative. So without thinking anything, you can put object distance as negative, whether a concave mirror or convex mirror. Since center of curvature and focus is lying on the right hand side or behind the mirror, so that's why this is positive. Next, in case of convex mirror, image always formed behind the mirror though it is small, and the distance of the image is taken as positive. So this distance from the pole to the image is taken as positive. Next, in case of a convex mirror, always an erect image is formed, thus the height of image is taken as positive. So this height is taken as positive. Now let us see what is there. Now this u, that is the object distance from the pole to the object, is negative. Image distance from the pole to the image is positive. Focal length is positive. Okay, so that is regarding the convex mirror. Let us see next thing. So this was a sign convention for both the mirrors, which we will take care when we will solve numericals. We have to put these signs plus or minus before the quantities. Next is mirror formula. Mirror formula shows the relation between the distance of object and distance of image and focal length in case of spherical mirror. Now students, I would like to add up one thing more. We have discussed that distance of object from the pole, okay, that is mostly negative, and you will denote it by small u. You cannot write such a big word every time, that distance object from the pole. Instead of that, use small u. And distance of image is represented as small v. Focal length is represented as small f. Okay, so let us see what is the formula, mirror formula, that is 1 upon v plus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. Always put plus here. Don't forget to write plus here. Okay, so it is 1 by v plus 1 by u is equal to 1 upon f. By knowing any two of the quantities, if you know v and f, you can calculate u, that is the object distance. If you know object distance and focal length, you can find out image distance from the mirror. Okay, so if you know any two quantities, you can find out the third quantity. Now next one is a magnification. Magnification is the relative ratio of size of image formed by the spherical mirror to the size of the object. So it shows that how bigger or how smaller is the image as compared to that of the object. Right, so in magnification is generally represented as letter small m. Small m is equal to height of image divided by height of object, that is HI upon HO, height of image upon height of object. Second is a relation among magnification. It can also be represented in the form of distances. So magnification m can also be represented as minus of distance of image upon distance of object. So m is equal to minus v upon u. And if we compile them together, we get m is equal to hi upon h naught, or h dash upon h is equal to minus v by u. Students, one thing I would like to tell you, that keep one thing in mind, that we have put in mirror formula here as positive sign. Okay, if you put here positive sign, so this is just for keeping in mind. Here in magnification, for v upon u, put here minus, that is just opposite. So this is a specific one for the mirrors. Right, now let us see what is importance of magnification. Since magnification is length of image upon length of object, so magnification of image is generally represented as minus 2 or plus 1. This you will see in the form of it, and without any unit, because it's a ratio of the two similar quantities. That is why these units will be cancelled and there will not be any unit you will see here. Okay, now another thing is that there is this negative and positive sign has some characteristic, and numeral value also has some other characteristic. Let us see what is that. positive value shows that image and object both lie on the same side of the line. That's why it's an erect image. So plus sign always shows that it's an erect image. Negative sign shows that it's a inverted and real image. Next thing, if numeral value is plus 1, this means it's a plane mirror. If numeral value is less than 1, this means it's a smaller image. And you know, smaller and erect image is formed in the case of convex mirror. And if you have a larger one, that is minus 2, or numeral value is more than 1, this means image formed is larger and it is real and inverted, which is always formed in case of a concave mirror. So this means this particular quantity is used for the concave mirror, and this is used for the plane mirror, plus 1. And if it is for the convex mirror, it would be plus 0.66 or plus 0.33. Okay, so it has a quite, magnification is very important, because with the help of magnification, you can easily identify what kind of mirror we are using for our purpose, or what kind of mirror do we need for our problem, that would also be there. Now let us see quantities for the quick revision. Quantity for the concave mirror and convex mirror. First is object distance. For the concave mirror, you will put minus sign before for the U. For V, it is minus sign for real inverted image, and erect and virtual image, it will be positive. Focal length, it is negative. Height is positive, which is positive on both the sides. And HI is negative for the, since it is formed on the left hand, this is formed on the above the mass, below the axis. Now for the convex mirror, U is negative and V is positive, focal length positive, HO positive, HI is positive. So all the quantities, they are positive except U. Whereas in a concave mirror, U is negative, V may be negative, F is negative, HI may be negative, and HO is positive. Okay, another thing is that what is common, which quantities are commonly seen in both of them, that U is negative in both the cases. HO, that is height of the object, is also positive in both the cases. This is one thing very common. Okay, and other things may vary. Focal length varies, V varies, and HI may vary. Okay, let us see. This is for your reference. Now let us see problem here. An object of 5.0 centimeter in size. This means this is height of the object size, is placed at a distance of 20 centimeter from a converging mirror. That means it's U, and you will put here minus 20 centimeter, since it's a converging mirror, or any mirror, for whether that's concave or convex mirror, U is always minus. Focal length is 15 centimeter. Now this converging mirror, so you'll put here focal length as minus 15 centimeter. Now question is, at what distance from the mirror should a screen be placed to get the sharp image? So we have to find the size of the image as well as position. V we have to find, and size of the image, that is HI, we have to find out. Let us see how to calculate it. HI is 5 cm, U is minus 20 cm, F minus 15, V we have to find an H2. And what we have used here is mirror formula. 1 upon V plus 1 upon U is 1 upon F. What you have to find out is 1 by V. So 1 by V plus minus 1 by minus 20. Don't forget to write here a sign, otherwise your numerical will be wrong. Is equal to 1 upon minus 15. So 1 upon V will be equal to 1 by 20 minus 1 upon 15. So V will be equal to minus 60 centimeter. So screen should be placed 60 centimeter in front of the mirror. Students, there is another way of doing this numerical. That is, 1 upon V will be equal to 1 upon minus 15 plus, you can shift here on this side, plus 1 upon 20, and then solve it. Okay, then you will get the same answer here. You can also use this method. And M is equal to H2 upon H1, that is minus V upon U. H2 you have to calculate. 5 is the height of the object. Minus is there, minus 60, as we have calculated here, and minus 20. So H2 came out to be minus 15 centimeters. So height of the image is 15 centimeter. So what we have concluded from it is that, since V is equal to minus 60 centimeter, this means this is on the left side of the mirror. माइनस मीन ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द मिरर एट द 60 सेंटीमीटर और इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर. सो दैट इज द पोजिशन इज शोन बाय द वी. नेक्स्ट इज नेचर ऑफ नेचर. वट इज द नेचर? इफ यू लुक हेयर एच टू दैट इज माइनस 15 सेंटीमीटर. वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दिस माइनस मीन्स इट्स अ रियल एंड इन्वर्टेड इमेज. दैट इज द नेचर ऑफ इट. Next is size. Size you can compare it with the H2 upon H1. That came out to be minus 15 by minus 5. That is 3 times bigger than that of the object. So this is a very simple numerical we can calculate by this method. Now next numerical is that an object is placed 20 centimeter. In first case it is placed 20 centimeter. In second case it is placed for 4 centimeter in front of a concave mirror of focal length 12 centimeter. Okay, so what we have seen here is it's a concave mirror, and what is it? It's a U for the first case and U for the second case. So minus 20 minus 4 will take, and focal length will be minus 12 centimeter here. Now what we have to find out is nature and position of the image. Let us see how to calculate. In the first case, U is minus 20 centimeter and F is minus 12. We have taken the mirror formula. 1 upon B plus 1 upon U is 1 upon F. So 1 upon B plus 1 upon minus 20 is 1 upon minus 12. 1 upon B will be minus 1 by 12 and plus 1 by 20. So we have shifted it here like this. So when you take LCM, this is the LCM. And ultimately what we got is V is equal to minus 30 centimeter, which shows that image is formed on the left hand side of in front or in front of the mirror at the position of 30 centimeter. This we have calculated. And of course, if it is on the left hand side, image is always real and inverted. It is never plus in sign. Okay, it is never virtual and erect. Next is U is equal to minus 4 centimeter and focal length minus 12. So again we put this formula, put it here in the values, and V came out to be 6 centimeter, which shows that since it's a plus in sign, so image will be on the right hand side or at the back of the behind the mirror. So it will be virtual and erect image. So it is very easy to find out with the help of these signs that what kind of nature of the image is formed here. Next question. An object is placed at a distance of 10 centimeter from a convex mirror of focal length 5 centimeter. This time we have taken convex mirror. So object distance, that is U, is 10 centimeter and focal length is 5 centimeter, which is plus 5. So draw the diagram showing the formation of the image. So what we have taken? We have taken a convex mirror placed after this place this line, that is principal axis. Okay, this should be F should be 5 centimeter and object distance should be double of it, that is 10 centimeter. This is what we need to make a ray diagram. But of course these rays can, you know how to sketch these rays, everything you know. Okay, but one thing is that how to draw such a large distance, that is 10 centimeter or 5 centimeter. Instead of taking them as such, you should consider that 5 centimeter is equal to 1 unit, or 5 centimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. So take from here, take it as 1 centimeter, from here take it as 2 centimeter, but don't forget to write here let. Let 5 centimeter is equal to 1 unit and 10 centimeter is equal to 2 units. Then put these values and find out what is V here. Okay, V came out to be 3.33 centimeter, which is behind the mirror, that is on the right hand side. So if we calculate it, we should also measure this distance, that is image distance. You will find that if your answer, that your diagram is correct, your value will come out to be 3.33 centimeter. Okay, so rest of the things characteristic you know about it. Next is question number 3. An object is placed at a distance of 6 centimeter from a convex mirror of focal length 12 centimeter. Again we have taken a convex mirror. Object distance, that is U, is minus 6 centimeter and focal length is plus 12. So find out the position and nature. So position and nature, so you will find it like this and you can easily conclude what is the position and nature of the image. Now next question, that is question number 4. A convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror in a car, has a radius of curvature 3 centimeter. Kids, now this time it's a radius of curvature, so you should make it half, that is focal length is 1.5 centimeter here. 1.5 meter, sorry, it's here. Okay, if the bus is located at a distance of 5 meter from the mirror, this means bus is an object and it is located as 5 meter from the mirror. So this is the object distance, that is u is equal to minus 5 meter. What is the position of the image and nature of the image? So we can find out 1 by v plus 1 by u is 1 by f. So v came out to be like this, 1.15 meter after solving it. Don't forget to write these signs. So ultimately what we find is that image formed is 1.15 meter behind the mirror, and image is also virtual and erect for the convex mirror, you know. So I hope you understood how to solve the problems here. Students, I have given an assignment of 30 questions so as to resolve all the problems related to the topic. So I think you should better try it and solve it yourself. Let us see what I have written here. Question 1 is on the focal length and radius of curvature. Second is again focal length and radius of curvature relation, radius of curvature and focal length. After that is concave mirror problem, where you need to find out magnification with the simple formula. Right, then question number 5 is related to the concave mirror, again with magnification is there. So you will use here m is equal to minus v by u formula and can easily find out the answer. Question number 6 is an object is placed 4 cm in size in place of a concave mirror. So this is for concave mirror, where the h naught is given, v u is given, and f is also given to you. You have to find out position, nature and height of the image, right? So position is with the help of v, nature is with the help of hi, and you can easily find out these two ones, that is nature and height of the image, by finding hi, right? Now next one is a converging mirror, that's a concave mirror. And the values are given to you. 1 centimeter height is given to you. 1 centimeter is the object distance, is placed 20 centimeter away from the mirror. So in this case, students, this real image is given of height 5 centimeter. So this is hi minus 4 centimeter, and object distance is ho is 1 centimeter here. Okay, so take care while solving this numerical. Now next again is for convex mirror, where we have taken a candle of size 4.5 centimeter, that is ho is given to you and u is given to you and focal length is given to you. So you have to find out all the parameters like magnification, or describe what happened when the needle is moved farther from the mirror. This I have discussed a number of time in other ray diagram also. Now next question is an arrow of 2.5 centimeter high. So again it is ho is given to you and distance u is minus 25 and focal length is given to you. Just like that, 10 question is on the convex mirror, then 11 again on concave mirror with all the possible parameters are given to you. Then question number 12 is given, where I have given this concave mirror with all the essential parameters. Then here again concave mirror, convex mirror, concave mirror, then another depending on the characteristic is asked here. Then next one is that of concave mirror, then convex mirror, and then of convex mirror is further given to you. Let us see 20 number question, where I have taken a convex mirror problem, then convex mirror, then again this one is of you have to find out focal length. Okay, and after finding focal length, you have to decide what kind of mirror is it, whether it's a concave or convex mirror. This is a different kind of numerical. Now next one is 23rd number is of convex mirror type. Next is a diverging mirror, again convex mirror, again converging mirror, concave mirror. Linear magnification of convex mirror is asked to you, is 1 by 3 is given and focal length is given to you. What is the distance of object? So you should try to find out how you will solve it. You should go first use the second equation and then you should move to the first one for finding it. Now next is focal length is given for the convex mirror, right? And what is the center, how far is it from the center from pole? It's quite easy, you can find out. Now next one is find the focal length of the concave mirror question is there, then convex mirror is there, then draw any three ray diagrams to show how the size and nature of the image of an object change when it move from the center of curvature of concave mirror toward the pole of the mirror. This I have already discussed in the last videos. So I have given enough number of question for your practice, students. You should practice so that this exercise will strengthen your this topic regarding the problems. So don't forget to take care of sign convention. What kind of sign should be taken for the concave mirror? What should be for the convex mirror? Before solving this numerical, you should write it on the notebook first. Okay, so what kind of sign you should take for it? Only then these numericals will be okay. Thank you very much for watching this video, and don't forget to share, like and subscribe it further so as to spread the knowledge. Thank you very much.